Hello and welcome to Living Supernaturally. We worship a God who is all-powerful, who is all-knowing, who is ever-present, and He's a miracle-working, supernatural, wonder-working God. And He's invited us to live a life in the higher realm, a supernatural life. And He's given us His Word, His wisdom, His instruction to direct us and to empower us to live such a kind of life. And today we are looking at the book of Proverbs and the wisdom that is there and the empowerment that is there as we carry out His instruction. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 9 and 10. Honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruits of all your increase. So your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine. So we see some instructions here. It says, honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruits of all your increase. Now, we have looked at honoring the Lord with our words, with our worship, with our hearts, with our lives. And this is another aspect of honoring the Lord. The word honor means something that is weighty, something that's heavy, and to regard someone or something with great respect and esteem. So we are called to honor the Lord. We are commanded to honor the Lord with our possessions, our wealth, and everything that belongs to us, to honor the Lord. So how do we honor the Lord with our wealth, with our possessions? Well, it is to acknowledge and go before Him and acknowledge and say, God, this belongs to you. Well, truly, everything that we have, all that we are, is because of Him, is because of His grace. And from His grace, from that blessing, we have received one blessing after another. So it comes from His hands. And the Word of God declares that we, in fact, belong to Him because He has purchased us with His own precious blood. So even we belong to Him, and everything that we have and all that we are is actually His. So when we acknowledge that, we honor Him. The second aspect of honoring Him with our possessions is to use that and steward it the way He would want us to. That would be to honor Him with our possessions. The second part of the instruction also is that we honor Him with the first fruits of all our increase. You know, whatever is our produce, our fruit, our revenue, the first fruit, something that is received first in place or time, to honor that, to give Him the first fruits. So Scripture talks about tithes and offerings and giving. So in our tithes to our local church where we belong, in our offering to the work of God's kingdom, extension of God's kingdom, and in our generosity to take care of the needs of people, the people who are needy. When we do that, we are actually honoring the Lord. In fact, when it comes to taking care of the needs of people, the Bible declares that he who has pity, he who gives to the poor, actually lends to the Lord. So let's learn to honor the Lord with all our possessions in the manner in which He has written down in Scripture. The end result would be that our barns will be filled with plenty and our vats will overflow with new wine. So what He's saying is that our possessions will be influenced, our possessions, there will be a change in the status of our possessions when we do that. And it'll be for the better. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for the instruction and wisdom that is in your word. And we thank you for the instruction that for instructing us to honor you with all our possessions and with the first fruits of all our increase, with all our revenue and everything, God. And Father, we thank you for the promise that Therefore, that will result in a positive change in the status of our possessions. Father, we thank you that you are true to your word, and may this promise be our experience, even as we honor you with all that we are and with all that we have. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.